All right, gotta do some unboxing. Where's my cutting tool for that? Perfect. Hi everybody, welcome to All Games New and Old. I'm David Rodriguez, and today I'm gonna be unboxing Black Rose Wars. This is the original, not the new one that just recently went up on Kickstarter. You know, when this was on Kickstarter initially, I wanted it really bad, and just couldn't reasonably afford it at the time. And so this is the retail edition, and I don't remember any of the extras that came with the original Kickstarter, and I'm really glad I don't, because then I'd probably want them really bad. And so now I get to just be happy with the retail edition. It's what I've got. I'm happy with it. I have backed the second one so far. We'll see if I stick with it. I think it's going to end very soon. But since they're you can use them together, I figured, why not? Why not? It's a good way to do it. So let's look at the back of this game and see what it says. So this is a game for 2 to 4 players. Plays about 90 minutes. Says you're supposed to be 13 and up. I guess it probably depends on the person playing. So it says, Turin, 1490 AD, one of the most powerful and secret lodges to have ever appeared on Earth, has found its perfect home in the magical city. Every 10 years, the Black Rose Lodge boasts numerous mages from all over the world to elect the new Grand Master, who will guide the lodge's decisions for the next decade. Several non-affiliated schools will seek the title among the great magisters of the lodge in an effort to gain access to its arcane power. You, too, can participate in the battle. Choose your school of magic and unleash your fury on the battlefield. But beware, the lodge is alive, and no mage considered unworthy will be allowed to sit on the Grand Master's throne. So it is a competitive fantasy game of deck building, strategy, and combat set in the heroic universe of Nova Aetis? I'm not sure I'm saying that right. So it looks to be like choose a school of magic, build your grimoire, and unleash your fury. So they give a lot of options for customization of your character. Now, it calls itself a deck building game, and I don't know if this is a deck building game in the sense of like a Dominion or something where you're actually building your deck as the game goes on, or if this is a deck building game in the sense of Magic the Gathering or something like that where you're creating your deck ahead of time and then bringing it into battle. So, could be either way. Either way, I'm excited to look at this. Looks like it has a few cool minis in here. So, let's dig in. Now, there's a big tear right here, which I could use, but I'm only going to use it as a backup because I get great pleasure out of using the old pizza cutters. Let me see if I can get it in there. Oh, yeah. Okay, here we go. Tears right through there. Nice and easy. Okay, put that to the side. That's satisfying to take the plastic off. I always find it really nice. Then I have to throw away the plastic, which is not as exciting, but still exciting. Okay, we got the plastic off, and we just have the box. So I'm gonna lift this big lid off. It's a pretty thick box. Oh, it has a silica gel pack. How exciting. Let's get rid of that. Okay, this is the rule book. Looks much like the cover of the game. And it is, let's see how big this thing is. Okay, 38 pages. Last page, at least, is the glossary. Oh boy, that is a big rule book, though. There's no doubt about that. So, lots of nice pictures. I'm excited about this game because it looks very, very colorful. Like, from the cards to the, I think you lay down tiles for the map. Just a lot of extremely beautiful colors, and the art in this is great. All right, there's a little look at the minis, but we're actually going to take them out, so. So, you know, it's a lot of pages, but it's not, it doesn't look super dense with text, and there's a lot of examples, which is great. I know that always helps me a lot. I imagine this game has been out for a while. There's probably several, oh my goodness. Do you see this? Wow. That's, being a little risky there with that one. Hopefully that doesn't cause them problems. So, we'll see. Alright, well, it's a little intimidating that it is that big a rule book, but it may not actually be that bad. Okay, now what is this? Doesn't say on the front. Oh, okay. So this, oh gosh, it talks about every single school of magic as well as the cards in there. That's fascinating. I don't know how much I really need to dig through all of this. I guess we can go into the schools of magic. There's conspiracy, destruction, divination, illusion, necromancy, transmutation, forgotten, and then has some stuff with the various characters and the lodges and whatnot. So I think it tells you what each room does. So this is sort of like a glossary of sorts of all the different parts in the game. So I'm going to move that aside. That's handy to have, though. I like to be able to look up everything in one easy place. Okay. We have the obligatory sheets of tokens here. Okay. So I'm not sure what they all are. Let me see if I can get this open here. Let me use X-Acto for this. Just do that. Okay. There's lots of things with the character pictures with red smeared across them. There's characters without red smeared across them. You have various shields. I'm not sure what all these symbols are. I imagine they're status effects, probably. There's a pleasures room, sanctuary, sacrificial altar, all kinds of stuff. Okay. That looks like these are probably character boards, I would go ahead and say. Perhaps. Or that's a character board anyway, maybe. I don't know. Interesting. There's a lot going on here. So, these look like maybe represent creatures of some kind. I'm not sure exactly how they work out, but looks interesting. Okay, let's see. Let's take this off of there. Now, what is this? What do I have here? Okay, now this is the player boards. My mistake. Those other things must just be a regular part of the game. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and cut this open rather than make you listen to me fiddle with plastic for a long time. That's not really exciting for anybody. Okay. So I'd be really curious if any of you have played this game. I'd love to hear your thoughts about it. I'm hoping to review down the road, but I can only do so many at a time, so it could be a little bit. We'll see. So we have Nero. He looks pretty mean. Oh, this is cool. It's got like a really cool full art of the character on the back, which I like quite a lot. Rebecca. I don't know. I think you can choose whatever school of magic you want to, but she looks pretty necromancer here. Let me flip this over. She's got the, like, skeleton staff, which is pretty gory, but I like it. I like that art. Cool, dark stuff. Jafar, who I'm going to assume is not the Disney Jafar. However, we saw someone that looked a lot like Mickey Mouse in the instructions. So, you know, maybe he is supposed to be that Jafar. You never know. They will probably not ever say that. But, and Tessa. Tessa looks tough as nails. Oh, she's like a fawn, or she's got like goat legs or something. I don't know if you can tell on the video, but there's recessed parts here, which I'm guessing are your health because it has the heart over here. So I love that. I absolutely love that. I hate it when they don't have that, to be honest with you, because it's very easy to knock cubes off your boards. Okay, I'm going to get a piece of paper here so we can look at these models better. I hope it's better. So this is Jafar, looks like. He's got all kinds of little things on him. I probably need to see the art again. I think it's weird that his little like kind of staff thing is just hovering in front of his groin kind of oddly, left from his groin, I should say. That's weird. But sure, you know, whatever works for you, Jafar. I'm not gonna judge. All right, this one looks pretty deluxe here. Look at that, he's got like cool magic effects around him. In the picture, he was doing a lot with fire, so I don't know if that's something specific to him or if it's just how they drew him. I don't know if it varies based on his school of magic. I like that. I like when models have cool magical effects on them. I think that just adds some fun stuff to paint. Alright, here's Tessa. She's got the cool goat leg situation. A lot of cool little detail on these models. I don't know if they're, you know, extremely sharp detail or not, but I think that they'll do the trick. I think they'll be fun to paint. Let's see, I got one more here. This is the one I said was like a necromancer looking. I don't remember her name, but they do feel like they're actually pretty heavy. Like the plastic is actually fairly heavy for the size that they are. That looks neat. I like long flowing capes, and she's like 90% long flowing capes and robes and stuff, so that's fun. Okay, so we've seen the models. That's great. All right, we have the obligatory cool plastic color cubes, which I actually like quite a lot. And I don't know what this yellow is. Oh, you know what? There's, I saw something, there's these little like rose pins you put on, I don't know if you put on your model or what, but that must be what these are, because these are all yellow ones. I wonder if I have different color ones. There's more cubes. Yeah, so there's green rose pins and red rose pins, and I think the blue slipped over here. Those are really neat. I think they'll probably be very easy to get lost, so I'll have to be extra careful with those. Okay. Conspiracy. So there's a lot of cards here, and I'm not sure what they all are. So, I mean here in the game in general. Oh, these are the different schools of magic, it looks like. So, okay. I wonder, okay, I am just guessing because I have not played this game, obviously. So, it looks like it has different kind of types of each one. So, conspiracy, you could be trap master. It looks like maybe you have these, I'm guessing they're spells, or you could be the quest specialist and have these spells. So, each one looks like maybe it has a couple different possibilities, which is kind of nice. It adds to the replayability, I think, because even if you, for instance, like the Necromancer, I know that's what I'm going to try, you might play the Master of Death one time, and the next time play the Cruel Corruptor, and perhaps one of those will feel more up to speed, or more your type of magic. So here's like a, it looks like a reference card, some room effect stuff. So I'm curious, I guess the different rooms will have an effect on you, and I don't know how integral that is. I played a lot of games where a room might have, like, a few of, like, the many rooms will have some sort of effect, but most of them don't. I don't know if that's the case here, or if it's actually most of the rooms have some sort of effect. Let's look at the tiles. If I can get this thing out, it's a little tough. I need, oh, there's another finger hole right there. Okay, great. I was going to say I need another finger hole, and there was one. All right, so let's tear this off. This is just paper, so theoretically it should be easy. We'll see. So I know, just seeing the board from afar, it looks super colorful. And I was curious to see how much detail it was, because I couldn't make it out on the things that I've seen. So this is nice, it has like a little table on there. Oh, they all have, okay. So a lot of these are more or less the same. They have like a picture with a wizard cap. Okay, now we're getting another treasure room. Throne room, the abyss, that sounds menacing. Summoner room, sanctuary, sacrificial altar, here, I'll put these down. The pleasures room, oh boy. The oracle room, are these different on both sides? They're similar on both sides, but one's a little bit more colorful. I should be showing you the more colorful side. Maybe I'll flip this. The arena, that looks cool, there's cool magical effects going on. The armory, the bibliotheca, so I don't know, sure. The black rose room, that probably is important in this game, I'm guessing. And they'll, I don't know about all, but a lot of them have recessed things around them too, so I don't know if you can damage the room or there's something else that you have to keep track of. Cemetery, crypt, forge, garden, alchemical laboratory, mirrors room, and the observatory. These are really pretty tiles. I go a little gaga for that kind of stuff. So, all right. So these are like just probably dividers, because I know I'm certain probably if you kickstart it, there's probably a bunch of extra cards and whatnot that you can get. I don't know if I want to go through all these, especially because they, at least from what I can see, they mostly just have text on them. I don't know how interesting that would be to look at in a thing like this. So there are some monsters, I guess. I might open that one, because the rest of these look like they're all sort of, you know, heavily text-based, magic block, I don't know. Okay. This might have something a little more fun to look at here. I'm sure that's not very functional, but I don't know how much people are really gonna wanna see just card after card that's loaded with text. That doesn't sound super exciting to me. And I'm not going to sit here and read them all, because I don't think anyone wants to watch this for, like, hours. Unless you're really obsessed with this game. But I think if you're that obsessed, you probably are figuring out a way to buy it if you can. Okay, so let's look at some of these cards if we can. So we have, okay, so Abominations, Andromeda. It's kind of an interesting looking character. Cerbero. Divine Altar. Infamy of Crete. Islandsnecht. Or Isensnecht, excuse me. Malakota. I may not be saying all these right. Obviously. Mutant Altar. Interesting. Bone Knight. Abomination. Okay, I went through them. So, I'm not sure how the monsters play, and I imagine you can summon them and have them do your bidding in some way, I'm guessing. So, that's all pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and put this blocker thing back in. So, that's all the components of this game. I'll make sure there's nothing underneath. I don't think there will be. No, doesn't look like it. Okay. So again, this is the standard retail version of Black Rose Wars. Whatever extras came with the Kickstarter don't come with this, and I don't want to know what they are. So, but I think it looks like a really cool game. I'm excited to try it out. I like when there's lots of ways you can mix and match your character and your abilities and that sort of thing, because it really lends itself to being able to play, be able to be played multiple times without experiencing the same thing over and over again. So I'm excited to check it out. I hope this looks interesting to you as well. And as soon as I'm able to do a review, I will. But I've got a few others in the pipeline between now and whenever that is. So be on the lookout for it. In the meantime, if it looks great to you, pick it up for sure. But that's it for this video. So if you found this helpful to you, please like and subscribe and click the little bell icon so that you can know the next time I put out a video. Otherwise, I'll see you all around the table again next time at All Games New and Old. Bye.